before we start. First of all, I just want to say a huge thank you to Jen for agreeing to do this program. And the other thing is that I'm going to say something, a few words before each of the pieces, and I've decided to dedicate this program to my former teacher named Camilla Wicks, whose violin I play now. I worked with her when I was a kid, and she passed away last year. Dear Camilla, how are you? I know it's a strange question to ask of someone who has died, but it still feels like you are here. You passed away last year, but I think of you often, and it's hard to believe you no longer exist. When I think of you, I picture the first place we met. I picture your apartment in the sunset, the upper floor of a light blue duplex where I came to you for lessons. I think of myself as a child again, standing in the living room, in front of you, sitting in the big gray chair. I was only 12, and you were in your 70s. That apartment had a pleasant, neutral smell, something like a mixture of body lotion and dust. I know it's an odd thing for me to mention, but that scent, more than anything else, triggers the feeling that you are in the room with me. I will never set foot in that apartment again. Lord knows you won't either. But I have something with me from those lessons. It's this violin. It belonged to you then, but now I play it, and it still has that smell of lotion and dust. And every time I open my case and take out this violin, I'm reminded of you and of our lessons. This first piece I'm going to play is called Souvenir, or Memory. It begins in the middle of a measure, in the middle of a beat, in fact, as if interrupting whatever silence or noise might be in the room before we start. And it reminds me of how memories come up, so often from a scent, interrupting whatever thought you had before, taking you from the room you're in to some room of the past.
Thank you.